Hi, everyone, and welcome to the You Have the Power To podcast. My name is Melinda Van Fleet, and I'm a certified next level life and business coach, mentor, Ahai 7D practitioner, business consultant, owner of Good Karma Sport Fishing with my husband Ryan, freelance writer, speaker, and best-selling author. I see people for who they are, where they are, and help them with where they wish to go. The You Have the Power To podcast is a thought-provoking and transparent weekly podcast that delves into relationships with yourself and others in business and life. My intention is to help you up-level your mindset, confidence, mental health, wealth, money, spirituality, and success. Because you know what? We all have the power to. Thanks in advance for listening. Now, hi, everyone, and welcome to this week's You Have the Power To podcast. I am so grateful and excited that you joined me today, because today we are going to be chatting about the brand new Activate and Ascend Your Business workshops. And I want to give a little bit of history as to how this has come about. And I want to share that history because if you are someone out there that has been on the fence and been thinking about starting something or leveling up your business, I want you to be inspired by my story and know you're not alone in your journey. I hope it's relatable to you in some aspect. And also then, if you are interested to join this workshop community, that would be amazing. And I would be so excited to have you be part of it, whether it's in person or on the Zoom. So before I dive into a little bit of background of how this came about, which is kind of like Mr. Toad's wild ride, I am going to share what it is as best as I can without spilling all the beans, because I do like to have a little mystery, and I also know how the internet works with other people. So calling a spade a spade. So what this is a 3-hour workshop that is kicking off Saturday, March 25th. It will be from 9 to noon Eastern, and it's going to be in person in Islamorada, Florida. I live in the Keys, at J. Kindred Art Gallery. And I'll share a little bit more about that in a minute. And I don't know the exact number of spots that I can hold comfortably, but it's not going to be huge. It's not going to be 50. So spots are going to be very limited. But then also, too, I'm going to be able to do it on Zoom. There are more and more in-person meetings that have a Zoom aspect. I just was at an event in Homestead, and they had some ladies on Zoom. So yes, it's possible. I love technology, and it's really great that we can do things like this. So if you can't make it to the Keys yet, you can definitely join via Zoom. It is $111. And one of the things that I really think is super exciting is that, heck, I live in the Keys. Hello. One of the most sought after vacation destinations in the world. So if you are thinking of taking a little weekend retreat, you can come by yourself, you can grab a friend, you can make it a full week vacation. Heck, it's a business workshop. What does that mean if you're an entrepreneur or 1099? That means you can write it off. That means you can write off your trip. Hello, genius, right? So I'm super excited about that because I love write-offs. And so that is really cool. And the other aspect of it is that I have really been watching for many years, not just recently, what's been happening out there in the land of personal development, whether your business is more, whether you are following coaches, let's say, in personal development that are more spiritual or more business, the more 3D. I've just been watching all of it for a very long time. And I'm sure that you would agree with me, and can raise your hand high, that the majority of people, after they attend a workshop, after they attend a conference, after they listen to a podcast, after they read a book, after they watch a speaker, after they do a Facebook Live webinar, whether you paid for it or not, rarely do the work. Rarely. If it's free, for sure. Super, super rare. I mean, the percentages of people that actually complete a course that they paid for is like, I think like 3%, I heard before. It's ridiculous. So I truly, truly, from the bottom of my heart, want to help people transform their business, transform their life. And in order to do that, you do need an aspect of repetition, a little bit of accountability, any which way you slice it, and just being in the vibes, like constantly being in the vibes, having maybe some homework, some to-dos, some strategy, some planning, whatever it is, and being like in the vibes to continue to do it. Otherwise, again, you put that little pamphlet that you got from a speaker away on the shelf or even in the garbage, and you don't even like remember what she said the next day. Like, seriously, this is an epidemic of what's going on out there. So it had been really bothering me, like, how can I address this? And I was trying to address it in the fall on virtual workshops only. And you know what? It's just a sea of Zoom. It's just a sea of Zoom. And to cut through that, to really have that grow at the pace it needs to grow, I just was like, you know, this is kind of exhausting and I needed to take like a little break from that whole process. So this is what came through to me is the in-person aspect, which I'm super, super excited about. So what does that mean? That means that on 3/25, on March 25th, it is going to be labeled as level one. And every month after March, there's going to be a level one and a level two. So for example, then in April, on Saturday, April 8th, there will be another level one. However, later in the month, April 22nd, there will be a level two. Why I'm doing this is because level one will be very grounding, going over a lot of information. And I don't want to always have to repeat that in every single workshop. I want the next level, after someone's kind of gone, okay, I get this. This is what we're doing. I've learned a little bit about Melinda, just so I kind of understand the background and the premise. Like, let's go. Like, let's set this town on fire, right? So I want the people then that are dedicated to be in a dedicated space with that energy, with the people that continue to show up for themselves and for their business. And it's definitely a different thing. I mean, there will be people that come to level one that I'll never see again. It's just a fact of life. But my hope is that over time, that the level ones go to the level twos and the level twos keep coming back. Whether you can make it every single month, that is obviously your schedule and your decision. But me showing up consistently to hold the space and to provide not only the workshop aspect of it, but also a networking aspect of it. Also, there's Q&A and there will be a high energy sessions included in this too. So I have a whole like plan and agenda that I'm just super, super excited about. So you make it through level one. Everyone has to do level one. Again, that's why it'll be offered every single month. And then after level one, you can go to level two. And then level two will just be a continuing come back and we're working on your business. We're not following my script or agenda in terms of that. We're working on your business for what you need, whatever your intentions are. So it's very specialized. It's very personal. And it'll just be like a really cool, cool experience. There is truly nothing else like this out there. I have never heard of anything. I've been in this space a long time. And this truly came to me. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is genius. This is how we're going to do it. So anyhow, so I'm super excited. Again, $111. Space for the in-person will be limited. However, again, there will be Zoom. So use the link in the show notes to sign up. And yay! Let's start like crushing the rest of this year. It's super, super exciting. Before I go any further, I want to share about another podcast. If you know me, you know I love to share and I love to collaborate. I love meeting other fabulous businesswomen, especially also if they're a coach. And I met another fabulous coach who has a really cool niche. Her name is Janet M. Taylor, and she is a fellow podcaster. Her podcast is called Got Clutter. And I love her podcast because if you had been listening to like Good Karma Success Coach before I put it on hiatus, you'll know that I had a little bit of a cluttering life change, I'll put it like that, in the fall. So in August, I started to get rid of personal development books. I still have some, don't get me wrong, but I got rid of like 5 bags of personal development books. I went through my bathroom closet after watching the Kardashians, and I got inspired by Khloe. And then, you know, my husband and I ended up moving, and honestly, still we're working through lots of different situations that have to do with space, downsizing space, and clutter. Going from a really large place to a smaller place is definitely, definitely a challenge. So I wish that I knew Janet way back when, because her podcast, Got Clutter, which is available on Anchor and Spotify, is incredible. Not only is the tips that she has incredible, but also her guests. She has amazing guests. She has expert guests. And who knew that getting rid of clutter in your life could be such a freeing thing and lead to magical manifestations happening? Because I swear, part of the reason why we ended up moving as how we moved was because I started this process. I released where we were living, and then I started decluttering. And then sure enough, what happened? Magic happened, and we ended up moving to a place that was exactly what I had been visualizing for the most part. There's a couple details missing, but we'll get there someday. So anyhow, I definitely want you to check out Janet's podcast, Got Clutter. Let me know what you think, and I will put her link in the show notes. All right, so here's the scoop on how this all worked out with this workshop. It is truly an incredible journey. Again, I want to share this journey for any of you out there that have been living in fear, afraid to start something, trying to figure it out yourself. Remember the universe? Like, we shouldn't have to always think of the how, and this is exactly how it went down. So I have been someone who has loved going to retreats and conferences for a very, very, very long time. So in December of 2021, I saw someone post, someone I don't even know, post a retreat that they were holding. I think it was a yoga retreat, yoga meditation retreat, something like that, in Isla Mujeres, which is Ryan and I's favorite place to vacation in Mexico. And when I saw her post, and again, I wish I could remember who it was, but obviously not important because it was the trigger for all this, I was like, oh gosh. You know what? I can do that too. Why am I not planning something like this? This is something I can plan. I had an event to launch my business in April 2019. I'm just a planner by nature. And I was like, why can't I do this? You know, this girl's doing it. Why can't I? And it was kind of like a trigger motivation. And so I sat and I journaled all about it. I journaled like all about it, where I would have people stay if they wanted to come, like all the things. It's all in my journal. And then I put it to the side because when January kicked off of 2022, I had a really big consulting gig. And the other part of the day, because it was every day I worked on this gig, the other part of the day I spent a lot of time writing for the paper and for other gigs that were writing focused. So I didn't really have a lot of time to think anymore about the retreat. And also too, we're still obviously still dealing a little bit with the pandemic. So I forgot about it. I moved on. Fast forward, in the fall, Ryan and I started to talk about doing retreats more and more and more. So he has a bunch of ideas. He has a really great community with both Good Karma Rigging Crew 1 and Good Karma Rigging Crew 2. So he's been like, you know, I want to grow. I want to do different things with them. And then I want to grow too. So we put together this very big manifestation, asking the universe, wish, dream, goal, however you want to put it. It's massive. It's actually like bananas. It's truly bananas. And I was like, okay, we're going to put it out there. We're going to see what happens, right? Because honestly, like, it is bananas. So then I was like, you know, do I really need to wait? What ended up happening then was I joined another coach's community, and she had a program that really just spoke to me for the time. I was like, I really feel called to do this program. It was for a couple months, and it happened that I signed up right before we got the news to move. So it was kind of like divine timing for me to have someone, another intuitive coach. She is also an energy healer that like understood things. I felt like just really kind of akin to that, almost more peer-to-peer than coach client. So I was like, I had joined the thing, and then I was like, you know, I'm going to share about this whole thing. And it just kind of came up naturally in our conversation. And she said to me, she called me out and on what I knew, why aren't you starting to do something now? And I was like, yep, you're right. I journaled about it in December of 2021. And you're right, I need to do that. So what then ended up happening was we ended up moving, which was completely chaotic. And many things went on the back burner. So obviously I was not going to be starting any new project, but I promised myself, this is the thing, I promised myself that I would at least start to resurface this thought process in March. That was my promise. I put it out there. I said, okay, universe, I'm putting this on hold. I have all these other things I need to do. My writing picked back up again. I attribute a lot of that to this move to this house. My business picked up with several new gigs, new consulting gigs. I got certified in a high 70 energy. So that's been really great. I've had lots of clients through that. And, you know, just really cool stuff. A huge human design project. That's been really fun. And so I was like, you know what? March feels good to me. March feels good. What ended up happening was I went to get my hair cut at J. Kindred in Islamorada, and I had known for a long time about their art gallery that the husband, Josh McNew, he's a very talented artist, had opened a little bit over a year ago. I think it was in like November of 2021, and they signed a 2-year lease, and they're not always using that space. So when I went to get my hair cut, Jamie and I were catching up, and she was telling me about the space. And we went to look at the space after my haircut. And she said to me, she goes, you know, if you need to use the space, if you want to use the space, if you know someone else that may be interested in the space, she's like, let me know. And I was like, okay. And I was like, you know, this is a really awesome space. And I kind of just put it out there. Like, I didn't stress about it. I didn't sit and like try to figure it out. I just like went, and I put it out there, right? At the same time, I had been trying to figure out, which does not work, how I could do the retreat with the concept also of a high 70 energy. And I was like, okay, I don't really want to have a typical women's retreat that sometimes ends up being more healing trauma vibe than my nature, which happens to be more business vibe. It's not that there's anything wrong with those retreats, but I also feel there's a lot of them. So I feel like if you're someone looking for a retreat like that, those are pretty easy to find. But a business retreat with energy is not that easy to find. I really don't know of any other one. So at the end of the day, maybe you can find something, but I really don't even know of the general concept of a business and energy infused retreat. So that was my overall vibe of like, okay, how can I do this? Where should it be? And then all of a sudden it clicked. I was like, well, wait a second. If it's business focused, we need to be inside anyways. We wouldn't be outside, because that was what was tripping me up. I was like, oh, everyone's in the Keys. Everyone's going to want to be outside because we're here in Florida in the Keys and we have palm trees and water, right? So that was my sticking point of my brain trying to figure something out. But when I let it go, it came back to me. It was like, well, if it's business and energy, it has to be inside anyways, because we're going to be sitting in more of a business type vibe, and I can make the room cool. So it's like got the energy healing practitioner vibe as well. And I was like, oh my God, that space would be perfect. And I have to tell you, it all came together really quickly once I let it go. Once I stopped trying to figure out, think about where, you know, I can borrow someone's backyard or borrow some space. Should I go to the trading post again? That's where I had my event in 2019. That's where I held meetups. I love that space, but it's so public. So I was like, I can't really do any of your energy work in this public space. It doesn't work, and no one's going to want to lie down on the ground. Like, that doesn't make sense. Like, nothing was like making sense. Nothing was jiving. Hotels are extremely expensive. I didn't want it to be a high ticket, at least at this point in time. And I didn't want it to take up everyone's whole day or their whole weekend, because that seemed to be not feeling right for me either. So this is working out perfectly that I have this amazing space to use where there's also parking. Yay. And that it's just going to be in the morning for 3 hours. It's not going to take up your whole day. So again, if you want to come here on vacation, if you want to come here for a long weekend, do it. Do it so you can spend the rest of the day at the pool. You can spend the rest of the day at the bar. You can spend the rest of the day on a boat. You can spend the rest of the day shopping. Like, do something here in the Keys. It's an amazing place to visit. So it just worked out perfectly. But again, the key was I surrendered. I let it go. I kind of held myself accountable to like a date, but I didn't even have time to get into March yet because the idea came to me the last week of February. How freaking amazing is that? So the execution ended up happening for March versus originally I was like, well, if I have the idea in March, maybe I'll be able to execute it in April. But again, I'm going to beat this to a pulp. I did not sit and figure out the how. I didn't. I had little drips, little thoughts, and I just kept putting it back out there. Nope, that doesn't work. That's going back. That doesn't work. It's going back. And then all of a sudden it came to me. I was like, oh, this is how I can structure it. This space is perfect. This is a price point that I think is very fair for people. The price will likely go up in time as this grows, but right now $111 I think is like more than like an amazing value, which I did a YouTube video about. I'm going to put in the show notes, but yeah, so I am super excited. So if you are someone that is stuck, that is living in fear, that is afraid to start something, or you need to get back on the bus and restart something with your business, ask some great questions to the universe and let it go. Surrender. And these are various aspects that we're going to be talking about and working on in these new Activate and Ascend Your Business workshops. So I'm super excited and I hope to see you in person or on Zoom. Give me a shout out. Stay tuned. Join my email list. You can just join it by emailing me at melinda@melindavanfleet.com, or you can go on my website and you can sign up for the Believe and Take Action free daily guide. That will put you on the list. That's an amazing guide. Oh my gosh. I need to do a better job of promoting that, really. It's so great. And get that freebie. And that will put you on the mailing list. And then you'll be in the loop on all the dates for the whole year as I come up with them. Yay. So good. Yay. So thank you so much for listening. I really appreciate you. And I think I'm going to stop it there. It feels good. It feels complete. So just remember, you have the power too. Thanks for listening.